Slovakia, a country of unusual natural beauty. Here you can still find natural rivers, meadows, and pastures providing homes to many animal species. There is added variety in the mosaic patterns of small fields, which of course mean a considerate approach to the land. People receive the gifts of the land with gratitude and humility. In many places, though, the situation is different. Intensive farming means large amounts of chemicals are used, and then birds are unable to find enough food. The race for profit from the sale of the timber means the forests are decimated, and then birds lose their homes. We've reduced their valuable living space, and we've put up all sorts of barriers to their movement. Roads, railways, tower blocks, and power lines too. Maybe we don't realize what it means, having electricity as part of our everyday routine. So, what about the birds? Unfortunately, they often pay the price for our comfort. Now we have decided to make a change. I'm Dorota Nvotová. I travel a lot, and I can see for myself how often nature gives way to people's interests. Slovakia is a transit point on several important flight routes for migratory birds. The routes are genetically encoded within them, and they've been flying them for a very, very long time. But then along came people, and with them, the need for electricity. There are now 35,000 kilometers of power lines all over Slovakia, which is the equivalent of the distance to the South Pole and back again. The whole country is woven with a dense network of cables, and the birds are trapped in a maze of snag lines. Collisions with power lines and electrocutions account for more than 10,000 bird deaths every year. All over the world, this amounts to several million victims a year. It's a good thing there are still people like Josef Hauko, who has devoted his life to nature conservation. When he and his colleagues approached me, I had no hesitation in joining them. I became involved in an important mission full of interesting activities as the face of the Life Energy Project. Working with them, I've learned a lot of things, including the impact that power lines have on wild birds.
Čakám tu na dropa fúzatého. To je najväčší vták Európy. A oni sú strašne, strašne ostražití. Preto som sa musela takto zamaskovať, aby ma nevidel. Vy ma vidíte. Ja sa nevidím. Ako sa nafúkla.
The great bustard has limited maneuverability and is not very good at avoiding obstacles. Would you believe that our dependence on electricity could affect the great bustard? But it does. When power lines started going up across the countryside, bustards were not able to avoid them and they started flying into the cables. This is one of the reasons why they are so very rare today and why they so seldom nest in this country. Power lines are a threat to many other species as well. Common cranes have a large wingspan and sketchy maneuverability too, and their collisions with power lines are well known in Spain, for example, as they head for Africa. With regard to Slovakia, we have recorded the most collisions of this type in the case of the Nutzwein.
Teraz sme na veľmi smutnom mieste. Tohto roku na jar sa tu stala taká dosť zlá tragédia. Zahynulo tu 22 labutí, ale kvôli tomu, že nevideli vlastne droty. Tu rastie repka olejná, tam majú dostatok potravy, tak oni proste doslova bez hlavo prileteli a no, nedopadlo to dobre. Čiže veľmi, veľmi smutný príbeh a dúfame, že sa nám podarí nájsť viac takýchto kritických území, presne ich zmapovať, ktoré to sú, kde sú a na všetky osadiť tie zviditeľňovacie prvky, aby sa to už nedialo.
Spravíme monitoring celej tejto linky až po križovanie so 110. Dohľadáme uhyny a uvidíme teda, či niečo nájdeme v jej okolí.
Flying birds collide with power lines because they don't see them on time. The biggest risk is during reduced visibility, for example at twilight or during the night or in a fog. Flying into the light can be dangerous too, especially at sunrise or sunset. You know what it's like when you're dazzled by strong sunlight. You have to screw up your eyes and then you can't see very well. Grey herons belong likewise among the largest species of birds. They tend to fly into their common roosting places at dusk. But often fail to see power lines when they're hunting, during mating flights, or when they ride an air current. That might happen to the majestic imperial eagle or to the distinctly smaller ruff-legged buzzard. This beauty is a white-eyed pochard, extremely rare in this country. Wetland habitats attract many species. The marshy areas around the Seine fish ponds provide food for egrets, the great white and the little, for spoonbills, night herons and seagulls. Any nearby power lines represent a risk of collisions due to the increased concentration of wild birds here. Collision with a power line is usually fatal for most birds. Those which survive almost certainly need immediate expert help. I took part in the treatment of an injured common kestrel.
Viete, ako úspešnosť intervencie veterinárneho lekára stále závisí, v akom stave je ten dravec, ako rýchlo k nám príde a samozrejme aj vybavenosti tej ošetrovne, či na to má všetky predpoklady, aby dokázal hociakého typu zákroky zvládnuť. A tým mi podajte. On si už na nás zvykol. To je naozaj nádherný samček. V dobrej kondícii. To pozrieme viac menej tým, že pred anestézou musíme vyšetriť, či ten dravec je v takom stave, aby zvládol tú anestézu.
Srdiečko a tak.
Veľakrát tam prídu vo veľmi ťažkom stave. Vychudnutý, keďže nevedel lietať, nevedel ani loviť. Keď nevedel loviť, nevedel ani prijímať, nemal príjem potravy. My ho uspávame plynovou anestézou, ktorá je najšetrnejšia voči ním, oni veľmi rýchlo uspia a veľmi rýchlo sa aj zobudia. Tento samček prišiel k nám s otvorenou fraktúrou, zlomeninou humeru. Tu vlastne je úspech týchto zákrokov stále závisí od tom, aby čím skôr viac menej ten dravec bol nájdený, čím skôr bol dopravený k veterinárovi, ktorý mu poskytne adekvátnu starostlivosť.
For feathered patients like this honey buzzard, we have rebuilt a large rehabilitation center and put up 2 aviaries.
Nachádzame sa na rehabilitačnej stanici pre chránené živočíchy. Vyzerá, pravdu povedať, dosť spustnuto, ale vďaka nášmu projektu sa bude rekonštruovať. Takže potom si môžeme pozrieť aj také tie zábery, že pred a po.
These new facilities enable rare bird lives to be saved. Apart from the ones needing urgent help, sometimes we get young birds here, which could have been brought up by an adult pair if people hadn't taken them away. Here you see young tawny owl and long-eared owl being brought up by people. Young blue tits are keen on animal protein, which they need for proper growth, so they eat loads of insects and worms. This young magpie must wait a while yet for its wing and tail feathers to grow fully, but this doesn't prevent it in the slightest from investigating its surroundings. After successful treatment, the birds can be released back into the wild. This long-eared owl has got itself a second chance. The issue of wild birds and power lines has been studied for more than 20 years in Slovakia. Together with the power companies, we have found ways of preventing injuries and deaths. The purpose of this nest support is to protect the stork family from electrocution. At the same time, it should prevent potential power supply outages. When the birds try to perch on a utility pole, they often short-circuit the life cables and the current either injures or kills them. There are several solutions to this. Suitably designed cross arms. Measures ensuring safer landing. In other cases, fittings which prevent birds from landing. Today, around 1/3 of all poles in this country have been made safer, with emphasis on the nesting areas of critically endangered species. Other measures are focused on protecting flying birds against collisions with power lines. Special devices are fitted in places where deaths commonly occur, increasing the cable's visibility for the birds so that they are able to avoid them. These measures are most important in areas lying along the migration routes, in nesting or feeding habitats, or places where birds tend to roost.
Prosím vás, povedzte mi, ako funguje táto vec.
S tou inou palicou dá sa na drôt, je to základne.
S inou palicou, nie s tou.
Áno, nie.
Teleskopy,
máte to, na každý prvok inú palicu.
Máme ich veľa.
Palička.
As part of the Life Energy project, the power companies involved used three products fulfilling some strict criteria. The moving high-vis device called Firefly, an orange spiral fly diverter, or black and white swinging strips. The locations are not secret, and you can find them on the map of sections with fly diverters. Windbreaks and copses, in other words, stretches of continuous woodland, in the vicinity of power lines also have positive effect. If the trees are tall enough and the woodland sufficiently dense, then the birds fly high above it and miss the cables nearby.
Teraz ideme za Romanom, lebo ja si chcem zasadiť svoj vlastný stromček a on to tu určuje, že ktoré miesto je na to vhodné. Čo sú to za stromy? Ktorý je ktorý?
Máme tu topole, máme tu javory a máme tu tiež vrby.
Ja si idem zasadiť svoj prvý strom, jaseň. Poďme, poďme. Ako hlboko pôjdeme vlastne?
Musíme vlastne zakryť celé korene. Hej. A tak. Ako keby tu ten stromček rástol normálne od prírody.
To čo je tá rúra?
Ešte sem dáme rúru, aby sem mohla vlastne bez problémov tiecť voda, keďže tie stromky budú mať aj starostlivosť na 3 roky.
Nech sa ti darí, stromu milý. No ukáž, čo ste urobili. Ale toto treba ešte zviazať asi, nie? A vy ste tu od rána dneska, čo?
Áno.
Koľko ste vysadili stromčekov?
67.
67. Paráda. 67 stromčekov sa zdá veľa na takomto úzkom vetroláme, ale v celoslovenskom meritku je málo. Preto musíme vysadiť ešte 500. Skontrolujem, či to dobre zafačovali.
An imperial eagle and a common buzzard come to inspect our work and the trees we have planted out. The renewed tree growth will be useful for nesting. We compensate for human impacts with other measures too, for example by installing nesting boxes and platforms in places where there are not enough natural alternatives.
Nachádzame sa teraz v krajine, v ktorej hniezdí sokol rároch. Je to jeden z takých viac ohrozených druhov vtákov na Slovensku, už iba niečo pod 40 párov. A bohužiaľ je závislý na človeku a na búdkach, ktoré mu človek stavia, pretože on hniezda nestavia. Kedysi hniezdil tuto v Karpatoch a dole boli sislištia a tam si chodil loviť sislíky, ale bohužiaľ, keď tam prišli poľnohospodári a celé to tam spravili polia, tak tie sislíky už tam samozrejme nie sú a sokol nemal kam ísť.
The Saker falcon has moved out into agricultural land in search of other food. In response, we have created new nesting opportunities for it, which it gladly makes use of. These Saker falcons hatched out in one of our boxes. The blue coloring of their legs indicates that they are young birds. Another endangered species in this country is the imperial eagle. It is called royal in Slovak because the light color of its head makes it look like it wears a royal crown.
Úžasný, úplne, úplne úžasný pohľad.
Thank you. adult imperial eagles can be recognized by the white patches on their shoulders. The coloring of younger eagles differs.
Je to úžasné fakt, že existujú takí ľudia, ako Jožo Chalko, že fakt si to obehá tie hniezda a stará sa o nich, krúžkuje ich, vylezie tam, postaví hniezda, ako sme spolu stávali tú podložku. Títo sú vo svojom vlastnom hniezdočku, je také strapaté z tých konárikov. Niekedy po búrkach býva problém, že im tie hniezda vlastne popadajú, tak potom ochranári zase nabehnú a postavia také ľudské.
Jožo, čaj!
Dokonca si radi premiestnia do toho ľuďmi postaveného hniezda, keď to ich už je také akože vybývané. Tak idú do tých ľudských a im tam dobre.
The most important prey for several raptor species used to be the ground squirrel. It has disappeared from many areas because pastures have been turned into arable land with large fields, use of chemicals and application of new farming methods. The Slovak name for these rodents means pasture squirrel because of their typical habitat, which is regularly mown or grazed grassland. We have renewed several historical ground squirrel locations in the past. Our present aim is to restore this cute little animal to the countryside in two places in the Slovakian Cars National Park. Once the land has been cleared of tree growth, mowing is carried out. We also provide extra feeding to the ground squirrels, thanks to which they have more young.
Máme takéto safári, že to človek môže fakt vidieť zislíka vo voľnej prírode. Je to vždycky iné, keď proste vidíte to zviera vo voľnej prírode a keď vám ho niekto proste takto podá z klietky alebo nejakého vycvičeného, hej, že... Našla som tu dieru. Tuto odtiaľ to vykúkol ten zislík, ktorého som videla pred chvíľkou. Tak idem mu dať trošku slnečnicových semiačok. Počkaj, nie to malo byť. Na, si.
Life energy is the biggest project of its kind ever to be carried out in Slovakia. In 13 of the most critical special protection areas, 80 people in the field monitored more than 7,000 kilometers of power lines, including 65,000 pylons. We found out which sections we should prioritize because of the number of collisions. The fieldwork was demanding and sometimes really full of adventure. The methodology was clearly laid down and it was very strict. But it was all worth it in the end. The sections of power line which used to cause the most casualties are no longer a risk for bird life. More than 8,000 warning devices have been fitted and 800 new trees have been planted out. In this way, we protect at least 600 birds from injury each year, worth of 1.5 million euros in value to society. Our monitoring confirms that the effects have been immediate. Instead of tragic fines, life has been restored here. Whole flocks of birds can now enjoy flying over a safe place.
Ja každému odporúčam, aby raz v živote zažil takýto podobný happening, ako som zažila ja pri natáčaní tohto filmu a vôbec pri realizácii tohto projektu Live Energia, pretože je to taká škola v prírode. Je to super, keď sú tu takéto združenie, ktoré vám to všetko ukážu a keď chcete a keď sa to zaujímate, tak naozaj môžete vidieť veľa. Veľmi si cením, že toto niekto robí a že sa tomu niekto venuje a že niekomu záleží aj na niekom inom ako na sebe samom. Čiže to, že som bola tohto svedkom, považujem za jeden zo svojich životných highlightov. A určite každému odporúčam, aby si niekedy proste dal time out a išiel do slovenskej prírody, kľudne za mesto, v ktorom bývate a pokúkal sa, že čo to tu vlastne okolo nás žije.